There's one contest happening soon that will have huge ramifications for the international community. That's right, the Eurovision Song Contest.
7-7-1-2-7-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-
It's a crucial role, as this person will be responsible for sending those angry letters that will stop ISIS dead in its tracks. And now, as the world is faced with soaring temperatures and sea levels, an ongoing conflict in Syria, and the worst refugee crisis since World War II, one man has decided he's up to the task.
My name's Kevin, I'm from Queensland, I'm here to help.
That's right, Kevin Rudd, the PM so nice he got fired twice, is reportedly campaigning for the top job at the UN. And I believe we have footage of Australia's response to that news. He's still yet to formally declare his intentions, which is Rudd speak for
"It's on!"
The job would start in 2017, meaning Rudd would have just 8 months to learn how to stop being bitter and also get that fringe under control.
Currently, there are 8 declared candidates, or as Kevin Rudd calls them, the greatest moral challenge of this year.
Among them is former New Zealand Prime Minister Helen Clark, seen here with Deputy Prime Minister Lord. With Rudd potentially competing with Clark for the top job, he can now finally live out his dream of undermining a female Prime Minister from a different country. But if Kevin wants this job, he's going to need a campaign idea as strong as rhyming Kevin with 7. Or failing that, one hell of an advertisement. World, say hello to Kevin Rudd. We think you two are going to get along great. Kevin Rudd was Australian Prime Minister twice. Does that make him twice as qualified as any other candidate? Yeah, sure. He's a candidate like no other. A man of boundless energy.
Tell him to cancel this meeting at 6 o'clock, will you? I'm going to have fucking patience to do it.
A man who's not afraid to find unusual solutions to world hunger. A man who can speak 3 different languages, English, Mandarin, and his own made-up language that only he understands.
Oh, fair shake of the sauce bottle, mate.
And he won't mind me saying this, but also a bit of a ladies' man.
He very physically stepped into my space, and it was quite a bullying encounter. It was a menacing, angry performance.
And if that's not enough, just take a look at the endorsements of Rudd from colleagues, like former Environment Minister Peter Garrett.
Helen Clark would make an excellent UN boss. She's got the right attributes to make a contribution on a global scale. Go, Helen!
Former Treasurer Wayne Swan.
The truth is that Prime Minister Rudd is deeply flawed.
And former Tourism Minister Gary Gray.
He doesn't have the courage and the strength that's required to do this job.
Kevin Rudd. Deeply flawed and lacking in courage. Guys, that's the UN all over. K-Rudd for UN. Australia had to deal with him for 3 years. Now it's your turn. Authorised by Australians for Bad Ideas.